Thank you all for coming. Before we get started the program, I'd like to say something nice about a guy that has really been instrumental in putting this all together today. I know Founders Day was initially Founders Day, now it's Founders Week, and this year, the credit for what's going on here and what's going to go on later this week is primarily due to one guy, Eddie Garcia. Where are you? Oh, there you are. All right. Again, thank you for coming, and I'll turn it over to Maggie.
Thank you, Tim. Good morning, everybody. I'm Maggie Skura with KNTV Channel 11, the San Jose News Channel. Very proud part of our name. I think if we look up in the sky, we'll take a deep breath and say, this is why our founders came to San Jose in the first place. And now I'm not going to give you any specifics about years, but when I first came to San Jose, I recall we were celebrating this city's bicentennial. San Jose was 200 years old, and now San Jose is 218 years old, bless its heart. I'm thrilled to still be here to be able to celebrate and amazed that time has flown. But also in that year, 1977, the city did an incredible celebration of the bicentennial. We also did a good celebration. We were in fact awarded for our efforts because it was a big deal, let's face it. But to be honest with you, I have not heard too much about Founders Day celebrations between then and now. And as Mr. Starbird just said, thanks to the efforts of Eddie Garcia, this has been a wonderful week. It continues to be a wonderful celebration, and always good for us to look back on our history and celebrate the terrific things we have in San Jose. We don't have a terribly long program for you today, but we are here to celebrate, and we will begin by inviting some of the children who are with us to come up and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. We have several children, fourth and fifth graders, from Schallenberger Elementary School. Will you youngsters come up, please? Ladies and gentlemen, if you would stand for the pledge. Thank you very much, Schallenberger Elementary School, for being with us today for this celebration. I'd like to introduce to you several people who are with us today. A number of our San Jose City Council members have made time in their very busy schedules to join us in the beautiful sunshine. Would you please say hello to Councilman Manny Diaz? Manny, who is not here yet, but I'm sure he's doing something very, very important and will be here very soon. He's coming. Councilman Frank Fiscalini, are you here? Frank is on the way. I'll tell you who I have actually seen and touched this morning, and I know they are here. Councilwoman Trixie Johnson is with us this morning. Trixie? Also representing the city, Councilwoman Charlotte Powers. And Councilwoman Alice Woody is here from District 8, my district. And I'm going to ask you to come up with me now, Alice, because Mayor Susan Hammer could not be here this morning, but she has asked Councilwoman Woody to say a few words.
Thank you very much, Maggie. On behalf of the Mayor and San Jose City Council, it is an honor and my pleasure to welcome you to this special occasion. I especially welcome the Consul General of Spain, Camilo Alonso Vega, and Consul of the Republic of Mexico, Fernando del Bayer, as they join us in celebrating this historic date in the timeline of our countries and our people. I also want to acknowledge, and as Maggie has, my colleagues on the City Council who are here with me. And also, I would like to acknowledge Superintendent Joe Cojo. On behalf of the Mayor of City of San Jose, Susan Hammer, please accept her regrets that due to out-of-town commitments, she is not able to join this celebration, but she sends her warmest greetings. The Founders Day celebration is as much a celebration of the diversity, cultural richness, and heritage of our city as it is a celebration of its birth. However, in celebrating San Jose's birth, we must also give honor to the Native American Indians that cared for, lived on, and respected this land long before we knew of its existence. San Jose's first settlers, representing the Spanish Crown, were people of many hues and ethnicities. I am very proud to say San Jose from the start and continues to be a multicultural city. Because of the foresight and bravery of these diverse people, San Jose was the first civil settlement in California. The distinction of being first city is followed by a distinguished list of other firsts. The first state capital, home of California's first governor of the American period, home of the first woman lawyer, Carla Oates, and the site of the first state normal school for teachers, San Jose State University, to name a few. Whereas the initial draw for the early immigrants to our city was our fertile soil and abundant crops. One of the draws today is wafers and chips of an inedible nature. As the birthplace of the modern electronics industry and the capital of Silicon Valley, San Jose continues our legacy as a city of firsts. It is with great pride that we observe our founding and remember the visionaries, the leaders, settlers, and workers who have established our home. Again, I want to join in welcoming you to this San Jose's very special 218th birthday celebration.
Thank you very much, Alice. I think that if some entrepreneur in the audience had these special Founders Day sun umbrellas, we'd probably do a little killing today. But sorry, folks, we'll be brief, but enjoy the sunshine. The weather's going to change. I have it on good authority. Councilwoman Woody mentioned very briefly two guests we are very honored to have with us. From San Francisco, I would like you all to welcome the Honorable Camilo Alonso Vega, Consul General of Spain. And also, the Consul of the Republic of Mexico, the Honorable Fernando de Villar. Thank you, gentlemen. Our keynote speaker of the afternoon, many of you are familiar with this gentleman. He is outspoken on a number of issues. We don't always ask him questions about his own particular school district. We ask him about a lot of things, and you know, he always has something to say. He has something to say to you this morning. Please say hello to Mr. Joe Cojo, Superintendent of the East Side Union High School District.
And, before I begin, I do notice that the Honorable City Councilman, Mr. Manny Diaz, is now here. Manny, would you please join us up here, sir? Big round of applause for Manny Diaz, City Councilman, San Jose. I understand that Councilperson Pat Dando is also here. A big round of applause for Pat Dando. Pat. I first, the good news is that this is not going to be a keynote address. but there are some important messages that I want to convey to you on this very momentous day and very important occasion. I first want to congratulate the San Jose Historical Museum Association for today's celebration. More importantly, for promoting the positive image of San Jose, for promoting the preservation of the Santa Clara Valley's heritage, and for inspiring civic pride in all of us. I also want to congratulate Eddie Garcia, who is the main spark plug of the initiative behind this celebration. And it's important that we do this on an annual basis so that our young people can continue to recognize the importance of San Jose and this valley. You know, as I reviewed the historical data regarding the founding of San Jose, there are three attitudes and themes that are particularly inspiring and motivating to me as an educator. The first of those is that as you read the history and review the materials, there is an ongoing attitude of optimism and positiveness and a positive outlook for the future of San Jose and Santa Clara Valley. That runs through all of the history that I review. A second one is a commitment to the youth, to young people, to the education, to the future. And thirdly, the valuing of diversity and the contributions, and valuing the contributions to the development of San Jose and Santa Clara Valley by the labor and the brain power of people of diverse backgrounds and cultures. Those three themes run consistently through the literature, through the historical data that I was reviewing. I'm going to give you a little history lesson as an educator, very brief if I can. Our history dates back some 3,000 years. The people that lived here were Indians. There were many tribal groups that spoke different languages living in this valley. The valley was abundant in wildlife, and the weather was mild. It was a very peaceful, a very positive valley. The beautiful valley we now call home was inhabited by the Muwekma people. That is, our council person was just saying, on November 29th of 1777, settlers representing the Spanish crown entered the valley and established San Jose as the first civil settlement in modern California history. The Spanish government, in an effort to discourage Russian and English settlers from penetrating Alta California from the north, began populating the area. In classic Spanish colonial fashion, the settlement of Alta California was executed by a three-pronged strategy: presidios, missions, and pueblos. San Jose's role as a pueblo was to supply the foodstuffs to the military presidios in Monterey and San Francisco. According to historians here in San Jose, the ethnic makeup of the 1778 census included mestizos, mulattos, Native Americans, criollos, people of European descent born in American soil, and a sprinkling of Spaniards. The Spanish-speaking people began a tradition in San Jose of hard-working families coexisting in a multicultural environment, in a multicultural, diverse society, to provide the outside world with the valuable goods, in their particular case, food for survival of the garrisons stationed in San Francisco and Monterey. Now, this legacy has not been lost on all of us who have followed here. After the first families, then came Mexicans and American ranchers. They were followed with people from Italy, from Portugal, from France, Japan, and Mexico, who came here to till the soil and harvest the crops for widespread consumption. Anybody have any water? Give you a breather. Mm. It's a good construction, that. I know that. I heard that word. He said that he never heard me at a loss for words. I think it may be this dust. In any event, people from all over the world have come and made a valuable contribution to San Jose. This year we are celebrating the city. We are celebrating its birthday by proclaiming San Jose as a city of firsts. In addition to being California's first city, San Jose was the first state capital of American California. The site of the first state normal school for teachers, San Jose State University. The home of California's first governor of the American period, Peter Burnett. And the site of the first regularly scheduled radio broadcast. The other first is represented by the young people, is that San Jose is also the first place where compulsory education happened in California. There's always been a deep commitment in this community for the education of young people. And I would hope as you hear the young people recite their poem that is very powerful, called We Are the Children, and placing children first has got to be our most important priority. You know, when you look at the data regarding young people in San Jose, you begin to see some not very positive signs. 44% of those that are homeless in this county are children. The incidence of child abuse in this county has increased dramatically. And I think that we ought to look back at our heritage and our legacy and know that historically we have always placed our children first. So I join all of you in celebrating today. I'm going to cut my presentation short, obviously, because my throat is bothering me. I don't know what the problem is. But I want you to remember that San Jose is a city of first, a city that should make us proud, and a city that invests in the young people of its city. Thank you very much.
Joe, thank you. And not only thank you, Mr. Cojo, but God bless you. I hope you're okay. We would like to recognize some other folks who have joined us. Among them, Assemblyman John Vasconcelos, standing in the sunshine. Welcome, sir. We introduced this gentleman earlier to you. We asked him to make the trip from San Francisco, and if he doesn't mind, we will prevail upon him to say a few words for our celebration. Please welcome once again the Honorable Camilo Alonso Vega, the Consul General of Spain.
Thank you very much. I had, in fact, prepared a few words, but the superintendent took with his historical erudition most of what I had to say. And I also didn't know that I had an intelligent audience composed of children. I was expecting an intelligent audience only of adult people. So with children, I cannot fool around too much, and even less with repeating things. But I see all these hands here, which I suppose they symbolize shaking hands. And I want to bring from my country, Spain, that had a little say in the beginning of this city, this message of solidarity between our countries and between all the citizens of San Jose. At the same time, somewhere in this city, in the historical annals, somewhere in this very house, which did not only belong to Peralta, it also was inhabited first by an Apache Indian. The name was Manuel Gonzalez. This shows also a lot to us in this history of civic pride that we want to today bring to your minds. Somewhere, I say, there must have been some coat of arms of Spain. And in this coat of arms, there are two columns that symbolized the columns of Hercules at the end of the Mediterranean. Spain was at the end of the 15th century, the far west of Europe. Spain and Portugal were the far west, pretty much like today. California is the far west. And at that moment when the discovery of America was made, those columns began to be franchised for the first time. The Greeks and the Romans believed that anyone that went west beyond Europe would fall into the abyss. Their ships would fall to the abyss. And with the discovery and with the first circumnavigation of the world, this was not so. So the King of Spain at that moment introduced these two columns into the coat of arms of the country. And what it before said, non plus ultra, do not go beyond, it changed the motto, and it now, since that trip in 1535, the first navigation around the world, it says plus ultra, go beyond. This is what I want to bring to your minds. I am sure that there are many happy developments in San Jose. There will be also other things that need to be surpassed. And with this motto, I want to bring optimism with this plus ultra to all inhabitants. Shaking hands of all of you once again, I thank you very much for the opportunity that you give me for being here.
Thank you, sir, for that charming addition to our history lesson today. And the stars of today's program, ladies and gentlemen, some children, they're going to read a poem written by their teacher, Pam Oliverio. Pam, is that you? This is Pam, right here. I want you to know that. Wave, say hello. Pam has written a poem entitled, it's on the back of your programs, We Are the Children of This Valley. I would like to invite the children to stand, and they will now present this poem to you. Once again, they are from the Schallenberger Elementary School. Schallenberger is the adopted school of the San Jose Historical Museum Association through the San Jose Unified School District's Adopt-a-School program. And Pam and the children, the fourth and fifth graders, I'm going to turn it over to you.
Good morning. My name is Pam Oliverio. My grandparents, Sylvester and Angelina Caselli, were married in St. Patrick's Church in 1891. My father, the youngest of six, was born on Vine Street in 1911. My five brothers and sisters were all born in San Jose, too. My fourth and fifth graders would like to present a poem I wrote, especially for today's celebration. Its title is, We Are the Children of This Valley. We hope you enjoy it.
We are children of this valley, of the golden hills dotted with oaks, of the marshes lined with tulies. We hunted and gathered the abundant riches around us. We lived with Mother Earth. We are Ohlone.
Somos los niños de este valle, corrimos con Deanza y Portola. Venimos con ojos pensativos para mirar este sitio hermoso. Trajimos los padres y el cristianismo. Nombramos esta ciudad maravillosa. Somos españoles.
We are children of this valley. We rode with Deanza and Portola. We came with wondering eyes to gaze on this beautiful place. We bought Padres and Christianity. We named this wonderful city. We are Spanish.
Somos los niños de este valle. Tocamos las campanas de la misión. Nos gozamos de las fiestas y los rodeos. Los ranchos se extendieron por toda la valle. La música resonó en todas partes de nuestro pueblo. Ayudamos a nuestro pueblito a crecer. Somos mexicanos.
We are children of this valley. We rang of nation bells. Fiestas and rodeos were enjoyed by all. Rancho spread over our valley. Music reverberated around our town. We helped our pueblo grow. We are Mexican. We are children of this valley. We came as fur traders and adventurers. We discovered the beauty of the land. We found gold in the foothills and riches in business. We brought statehood. We are Americans.
Now they like gum some house some food, cow some wood. Drop for chalo, sai chisa, choy yao, gum ya, think jiao, doja pakon, ye ye.
We are children of this valley. We came to the golden mountain in search of wealth. We built the railroad. We toiled to please others. We rose from adversity. We are Chinese and Japanese.
Noi siamo la gioventù di questa valle. Venimo portando frutta, prugne, albicocche, ciliegie, mostarda, finocchio, anice. Davanti andamo le colline fioriane, trovamo la nostra valle di chiodi felici, siamo francesi ed italiani. We are children of this valley. We came bearing fruit, prunes, apricots, cherries, mustard, fennels, anise. Wherever we went, the hills blossomed. We found our valley of heart's delight. We are French and Italian.
We are children of this valley. Find a more peaceful life, to leave behind the frost and cold. The industry was booming, and we worked hard for our children. We helped our city grow. We are soldiers and sailors of World War II.
Chúng ta là trẻ em của thung lũng này. Chúng ta đến trong sự hải sợ để tìm một mái ấm mới. Chúng ta mang đến một văn hóa đa dạng, một lòng kính trọng dành cho việc giáo dục và một sự trong tôn trọng dành cho công việc khó nhọc. Chúng ta là người Việt Nam, là Campuchia.
We are children of this valley. We came here to find a new home. We brought infusion of culture, a new reverence for education, and respect for hard work. We are Vietnamese, Laotian, Cambodian.
Children of this valley, our hills are lined with houses, but the oaks still grow in our schoolyard. We are the grandchildren of our founders. We are the hope of our parents. We are the children of this valley. We are the future.
You did a great job. You did a great, you can smile now. Does that feel better? We never practiced with a microphone. And from all of us, from the bottom of our hearts, Pam, that was a beautiful poem. The sentiments were beautiful, the children were wonderful. Please thank them once again if you don't mind. And our final speaker of the day before cake, please say hello to Eddie Garcia, the gentleman who brought us all here today. He is representing San Jose Historical Museum. He is chairman of the 1995 Founders Week events. Eddie.
Thank you, Maggie. We promised a brief program, so I'm going to make it very short, and especially because I can see some of the students here eyeing the cake already. So we're going to make it short. Today is an exciting day, and it's a proud day for San Jose. We've been here for 218 years since the founding, but we didn't really have a celebration. As Americans, all of us here, we look at fireworks and we get excited about the 4th of July. We have something that we can be proud of. Now, San Jose has something we can be proud of. The founding of San Jose in 1777. We're almost as old as the United States itself, and this is a great day for us. So I want to take this moment to acknowledge some very important people, dedicated people, that made this happen. First of all, I want to acknowledge Supervisor Blanca Alvarado, who could not make it this morning because she's ill. As Vice Mayor of San Jose, Blanca made this thing happen. She had the vision and she had the leadership to make this event happen, so I think we should all thank her when we see her somewhere down the road. Another very important person is Fernando Zazueta. Where is Fernando? He's holding up the stage there for us. Now Fernando, yes, he definitely deserves a hand. Fernando is the person that pushed the city and pushed all of us to make this happen. He loves history. If you get a chance to sit and talk about history with Fernando, he will talk until he can't talk anymore about it. He's proud of being from San Jose, and I think we should all be just as proud as he is. Thank you, Fernando. Another person we should thank is Kathleen Muller. Where's Kathy? There she is. Kathy is... Kathy is the executive director of the San Jose Historical Museum Association, and I describe her as the heart and soul of Founders Week. She's there every day making all the things happen. The chairs you're sitting on, the birthday cake, the flags, the stage. It's Kathy. She's done a wonderful job, and I think we should all give her one more hand. I also want to thank Councilmember Woody and the City Council for making their special trip to this event today. I want to thank Superintendent Cotto, and I've also made a mental note that I'll never ever again, when I put on an event, speak after Superintendent Cotto, because he's definitely a hard act to follow. I want to thank the foreign dignitaries from Spain, the Honorable Camilo Alonso Vega and the Honorable Fernando de Villar from Mexico. Thank you for being here. When you all get a chance, look in your program and you have listed the Founders Week Committee. Now this is a perfect example of dedicated civic leaders, and I'm really proud and I thank you also. I want to thank Arte Flamenco for entertaining us just before the event, and I think they're going to dance a little bit after, I'm not quite sure. Yes, they are, thank you. And this is Robert Garcia, who is the executive director of Arte Flamenco, chairperson. Thank you. I want to thank the students from Schallenberger. I was sitting here watching you, and I thought to myself, this is what symbolizes the greatness of San Jose, right here. I appreciate the Chamber of Commerce for printing the programs you have in your hands. The Franklin McKinley School District children made beautiful hands that the Honorable Alonso Vega referred to earlier. They did a beautiful job. I want to make a special thank you to Maggie Skiro from KNTV Channel 11. And talking about the cake, Carl Buchta, the general manager of the Fairmont Hotel, is here somewhere. There he is. Thank you. And your executive chef, Brad Nelson, is also here. Nope, he's not. He's cooking. Good for him. And he made a beautiful cake. Real quickly. Tomorrow at 9:30 in the morning, and this is especially for you guys in the press over there, where we, the San Jose Historical Museum Association, in collaboration with the Santa Clara County Office of Education, will introduce a new curriculum that talks about everything we talked about today. And it's gonna be at Terrell Elementary School at 9:30 in the morning, and Mrs. Hirschbach's class, is that you guys over there? They've been working hard, at the program and at the curriculum, and they'll show us something exciting tomorrow. Also tomorrow at 3:30, Dr. George Vasquez of the History Department at San Jose State University will give a lecture on the founders of San Jose. It's at 3:30 at Washington Square Hall, room 109 at San Jose State. And also, the San Jose Historical Museum Association just finished an extension of our exhibit downstairs in the Fallon House. I invite all of you, when you get a chance, maybe today, to walk on out there. And it talks a little bit about our Italian heritage of this city. And it's a very beautiful exhibit. It just opened up. So with that, what I want to do is invite everyone up here on the stage to walk on over to the birthday cake. And we're going to have the children from Schallenberger and Terrell lead us into probably the most popular song in the history of the world. We're going to sing Happy Birthday to San Jose. You guys ready? Okay, on three, you guys are going to start. You ready? One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear San Jose. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, thank you, everyone, and stick around and have a little piece of cake. Bye-bye. We'll see you next year.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We are Arte Flamenco. This is Andrea La Canela, Roberto Dali. And this is Elena, and I'm the artistic director. My name is Diana Alejandre. We are Arte Flamenco. Thank you very much for having us here.